Lee Building has always had a unique future and present in education. Mr. Hammonds, who was president of Northeastern in the early days, and Mr. Vaughn, and on our Public Board of Education, names that Tahlequah citizens will know, Alden Dryden, who was a local businessman, Bertha Parker, who received a national recognition for her work with military groups and was a prominent businesswoman, was they were both on the Board of Education, and there was always a vision for this building. And now you, as Dean of the College of Education, join with other of the administrators, and there is a vision for the continued use of this building. And would you address that, Dr. Grant?
Well, we're very excited, as I mentioned, to be able to restore the third floor to the building, and in a different form, not quite the same, but we'd had a vision. We've talked about raising the roof, literally, in terms of putting the third floor back on, as well as raising the level of programming. And so we had wanted to kind of make it a high-tech center in terms of moving our existing computer lab and our existing interactive television classroom, where we can beam meetings and classes back and forth between our own campuses and other the state regents and the State Department, that kind of thing, as well as help to provide an opportunity for our teacher candidates to experience tutoring in reading and as an outreach to the community. And we are very excited, just within the last month, to have received $1 million donation from Greg Wadley and his wife, Betsy Brackett. And with this money, we're going to be able to begin the renovation of the third floor. And $500,000 will go to the renovation, and another $500,000 will go to the beginning of two endowed professorships, so that we can try and have additional faculty to allow for this expansion. So we are very excited, and it's been a vision of what we wanted to do. We had hopes, but I think it's going to be able to come to fruition even faster than maybe what we had hoped for with this incredible donation from the Wadleys.
What will be the definitive focus of the two endowed chairs? Has that?
They would be for the reading
and
computer technology programs. And like I say, we have a reading clinic, a new one on our Broken Arrow campus, and it supports the master's in reading specialists, as well as does an outreach to the community. And we've certainly seen the need here. We're excited to work with Tahlequah Public Schools and the surrounding areas. Certainly we have children in this area who have problems with reading.
Yes.
And so it can, like I say, provide guided experience for our teacher candidates. It can provide direct service to the community. It can also be a place where professional development can be provided to parents as well as to teachers.
And that's so important.
So we are very excited about this. Greg Wadley, his mother was a teacher and a librarian.
And his father was on the faculty here.
Yes, yes.
And he went to Bagley.
Yes, he did.
And we are
very excited that this will be the Cappy Wadley Reading Clinic, and in honor of his mother. So we are so pleased to have him invest in us as a suitable memory for his mother, and the commitment that she had to helping children learn and the importance of education and certainly of reading. So this is an exciting development. We made the public announcement at the Emerald Ball right at the beginning of December. And so we have been starting conversations, and we're hoping to begin construction just as soon as we can get the details worked out.
I think it's so very interesting. As we talk, names keep coming to mind. A returning to this community is a former student who had Mrs. Felicia Payden in the first grade room just down the hall that's been renovated into an office. Mrs. Felicia Payden was a first grade teacher here and later taught Spanish. And the woman who has returned to the community is Ann Lancaster, and her father was Mr. Lookabaugh, who was on the faculty. There are so many names that pop into my mind that have a relationship in some way to education in this very building. And I, as you were talking, I was thinking, now, you have a reading lab on the campus now.
We have we don't have a reading lab on the Tahlequah campus right now. Like I say, the reading clinic, we have a reading program in terms of all of our early childhood, elementary, and special ed teacher candidates take three reading classes. So we have undergraduate reading classes here. But we're very excited about the prospect of, with the reading clinic, being able to hopefully expand our master's reading program back into this community. Mm-hmm. It started here. Mm-hmm. And the reading clinic,
yes,
and then
yes.
moved to Muskogee,
yes.
And then with the Vision 2020 money from the Tulsa area,
yes.
Some of that was used to adapt space, and so we have a state-of-the-art reading clinic on the Broken Arrow campus, and we're very excited to be able to say that we're going to be able to have something comparable now back on the Tahlequah campus.
And educators here and in this area and business people will be delighted, I'm sure,
yes.
to know that this is true.
And I think once we have the facility, we'll be able to expand and seek additional funding that would allow us to provide other kinds of programming, both for family literacy, adult literacy, and for those other kinds of programs that would even provide additional support for the area and the community.
Do you have any plans, even niggling around in your mind, about some collaboration with some of the programs through the cooperative, the Willis, Bill Willis Skill Center and those things? You have any vision of any cooperation there?
I think
there?
It's one of those where we're only limited by our imagination and our oomph at the end of the day.
Right.
And we are certainly having even more emphasis for collaboration and partnerships. So we are open to any and all ideas that people might have. We'd welcome them giving us a call.
Mary Lou Purdy, whom I mentioned a little bit ago, was very instrumental as a teacher in this area and worked with the Zelma Willis Early Childhood Education Program, and that brought to mind the possibilities for,
sure.
for collaboration. Well, Dr. Grant, I think our time is running out, and it's been such a pleasure to have you here to talk about this historic building and its future, which will be of great impact upon education in this area, I'm sure.
Well, we're very excited. Having completed the centennial this year, we're anxious to launch into the second century, and I think with the renovations that we've got, it will serve us well into that next period of time.
I think so too, and I think it's just wonderful that the vision that came into existence in 1927 has not died.
That's it.